Friends, out of affection for these two, Drew and Rihanna, we've gathered together here to witness and to bless their mutual vows, which will unite them in marriage. To this moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts. They bring it as a treasure to share with one another. They bring the dreams that bind them together. They bring that particular personality and spirit which is uniquely their own. And out of that, they will form a life together. I rejoice with them, and you should also, as we go into this outward symbol of the union of hearts, a union that's been created by friendship, respect, and love. You have been invited to share in this happy and holy occasion, and it's a time of worship. It's wedding service. It's a service of worship in which a covenant is established between husband and wife here in the presence of God. You're present to join in this time of worship. Therefore, let me invite you to meditate and to pray with me just for a few moments. First, from the Old Testament, the book of Ruth. Entreat me not to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord do so to me and more, if even death parts me from you. And the scripture says the two of them went on together. And then from the New Testament, from the 13th chapter of the book of 1 Corinthians, tremendous words that tell us love is very patient. Love is kind. Love knows no jealousy, makes no parade, gives itself no airs, is never rude, never selfish, never irritated, never resentful. Love is never glad when others go wrong. Love is gladdened by goodness, always slow to expose, always eager to believe the best, always hopeful, always patient. And that passage ends with, love never fails. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we acknowledge that you are the source of infinite wisdom. We ask that you would bless us now with a sense of your indwelling presence as we worship here. Keep us sensitive to the wonder of things that fill our days and give meaning to life. Deepen in us to the level of our loving, both for those who are near and dear to us, and for those even who are strangers, those who need our concern. Especially now, we pray your divine blessing on these two, Andrew and Rihanna, who come here in this high moment of their lives. Be near to them as they make their promises to each other, that they shall pledge their vows with deepest sincerity, knowing full well the meaning of the words they say. And do grant to us all, we pray, a heightened sense of the joy of life because we share this moment with them. In your loving spirit we pray. Amen. I charge you both, Drew and Rihanna, as you stand here in this high moment of your lives, to remember that love and loyalty alone will stand as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. If the vows you make today are kept, your life together will be full of joy and peace, and the home you make will be able to abide through all of the unknown future. In this new life together, I counsel you to remember the thrill of your new love. Cherish always the visions that you have and the hope that you have this day. Believe in your ideals for this marriage. Diligently pursue them. I charge you both too to make your love for each other a growing part of your lives, feeding it from the very best resources of your living. Give of yourself to the other, deeply, freely, generously. Yet it's also necessary to recognize that marriage is a relationship of two people who aren't always at their best. Work by those places. Have compassion for one another. Share the spirit that is expressed in God's love. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted and forgiving. And finally, I charge you both. I would require you both to remember this day as the most sacred day of your life, a day in which you promised before these people, before God, that in every way possible you will strive to bring each other life's greatest fulfillment. Drew, do you take Rihanna to be your wife, to live together in the holy bond of married life?
I do.
Do you promise to honor and uphold her and to join with her in making a home that shall endure in love and peace?
I do.
Do you affirm your purpose of a deeper union with her, whereby you both shall know joy and the fulfillment of love?
I do.
Do you pledge to her your complete faithfulness through all the changing experiences of life? And of your own free will, do you now give yourself to her completely, that from this day forth you shall be hers so long as you both shall live? Rihanna, do you take Drew to be your husband, to live together in this holy bond of married life?
Yeah.
Do you promise to honor and uphold him and to join with him in making a home that shall endure in love and peace? Do you affirm your purpose of a deeper union with him, whereby you both shall know joy and the fulfillment of love?
Yeah,
do you pledge to him your complete faithfulness through all the changing experiences of life?
Yeah,
and of your own free will, do you now give yourself to him completely, that from this day forth you shall be his alone, so long as you both shall live? Please join right hands. Repeat after me. I, Drew, take you, Rihanna, to be my wife.
I, Drew,
take you, Rihanna.
Take you, Rihanna.
To be my wife.
Yeah.
Yeah. To have and to hold from this day forth.
To have and to hold from this day forth.
Through all the changing experiences of life.
Through all the changing experiences of life.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live.
To this I pledge you.
To this I pledge you.
My solemn vow before God.
My solemn vow before God.
Repeat after me. I, Rihanna,
mm-hmm.
take you, Drew, to be my husband.
Take you, Drew, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forth.
To have and to hold from this day forth.
Through all the changing experiences of life. To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
To this I pledge you.
To this I pledge you.
My solemn vow before God.
My solemn vow before God.
What tokens do you give in commemoration of this pledge? These rings serve as a symbol of the vows that you've just spoken. They are the outward and the visible sign of an inward and invisible love which binds your hearts together. These are of the finest of earth's materials, so your love is of the richest of spiritual values. As these rings are without edge or seam, having no beginning and no end, so they symbolize the perfection of a love that must not end. Let us pray again. Bless these rings, O Lord, that in giving them and receiving them, Andrew and Rihanna may be strengthened in the commitment that they make this hour. Let them dwell in your favor and continue faithful to each other and to you throughout all the days of their lives. Amen. Rihanna, will you accept Drew's ring?
Yes.
Place the ring on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
A symbol of my enduring love.
A symbol of my enduring love.
I ask that you take it and wear it.
I ask that you take it and wear it.
That all may know.
That all may know.
You are touched by my love.
You're touched by my love.
Drew, will you accept Rihanna's ring?
I do.
Place the ring on his finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
A symbol of my enduring love.
A symbol of my enduring love.
I ask that you take it and wear it.
I ask that you take it and wear it.
That all may know.
You are touched by my love.
You are touched by my love. Please join hands. For as much as Drew and Rihanna have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company and have pledged their faith each to the other and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are man and wife together, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Flanagan. You may kiss your bride. Thank you. already know cake is in the back. I presume punch is there too. They'll form a receiving line back here, and you won't have to get outside in this heat.
We also could have locked them out.
You know that's an idea.
We also have brisket.
We've got brisket. Jim, did you know that?